Guess what? I just put my logo in my boot. Guess what? I just made a porno in the booth. Guess what? Maybe taking photos when I move. Guess what? Damn. Only thinking vertical. Run the marathon from top to bottom. Roll some personals. My plan is a convertible. My Porsche's name is Percival. I study this shit inside out, but I am not reversible.
Hairbrush, me and Russ come in like we dress new.
6'4 apologies.
Just the way we play with Lou.
Big bank baller in it, baby. I'm known as you. Go on over, start, she be the mood. It's no love for haters, so far from neighbors.
Guess what, yeah, I just put my logo in my boot. Guess what, I just made the porno in the booth. Guess what, they be taking photos when I move. Guess what, I still got control, how about you? Guess what,
Willie B, if we have a veteran in the game, a young man who's really dug into this business, a fella by the name of Russ, he hails from New Jersey, so he's Sicilian descent. He's got three other siblings, so, you know, a nice big family. His father, they moved around a bit. They moved to North Carolina when he was very, very young. He ended up finally moving to Atlanta, and that's kind of where he continued his school career and was able to graduate. So he was rapping very young. You know, he was like 8 years old, 9 years old, making raps. His father taught him how to play guitar. You know, by the time he was 14, he started producing beats, making beats on his beat machine, and really starting to hone his skills in quickly. He's friends with this kid named Buggus. I don't even know if I'm saying that right, but it sounds like that's right. Who also makes music. And Buggus, he was on MTV, so he started to get a little shine before Russ. He was creating a label around this time with Buggus and a few of their friends. It was called Diamond. And so he was kind of trying to be like the in-house producer, since he could produce for his own label. He was really trying to shoot to the top very early. 2011, this motherfucker, he just started releasing songs. He like 11 albums in a span of 4 years. But it wasn't getting him the traction he wanted. But then he started going on SoundCloud, putting out track after track after track. And the consistency of that, he started to grow a buzz, man. He signs with Columbia Records, I guess, to push it even more. He releases his 12th album, but it's his first commercial album. There's Really a Wolf, 2017 comes around. He drops Zoo. 2020 pandemic year, he drops Shake the Snow Globe. It leads us right here to Chomp 2. He just dropped, which is an album, but he obviously had an original Chomp project, which he didn't put out as an album. He did, but it wasn't a commercial album.
J1, Chomp 2. Okay, I like all my women to be sex crazed. Models trying to put my hair in French braids. This industry is high school. Grown men and women acting like they still in 10th grade. I don't care what your friends say, I'm legendary. I love my girl, but when it scare me, I can't fight the force. My dad is twice divorced, might be hereditary.
So Russ is opening up, just spitting. You could tell he's setting a tone kind of to where he's going to take this. And I like this because actually he's kind of just showing that he can just keep it simple bars. Now, these ain't the greatest bars ever, but it's a great warm up. It's like just to show you, hey, I can spit. Nigga, you know, like, don't try to put me in a box with some bullshit ass niggas. Like, I can actually spit. And this shows it. A cool beat, just simple. But mainly just showing you his skills.
Yeah, I just hit the joint before I wrote this. Record label Rebel, remember opening that Omis. Always saw the ocean, always futuristic. 2018, I made the Forbes Cash Kings list. A wave of depression and anxiety for Christmas. But I can never drown, I rose Kate Winslet. Gassed up, took a quick trip to my hometown. Girls that were curving me, turning to my hoes now.
See the beat? He must be taking it back to his super roots. He's going back to like Syracuse, New Jersey with this shit. You know what I mean? With the beat wise. He trying to appeal to motherfuckers where he was born at this point. With the beat wise. This feels like some old like Rockefeller shit. And then he come in just spitting. He's even more dynamic than he was on that first record with his rhymes right now. He's getting more intricate. And it's growing on me. Like, I've already knew that Russ could spit. I already knew he could spit. But I just don't know how deep he can go into it. Can he be conceptual? Can he give you the story within the story? Can he just get you stuck on what he's saying? Like, this is what I'm discovering of him. So you got Ransom coming on here. Ransom did his thing. Ransom did what Ransom does. Just a lyrical assassin. And you get it if you get it. It's kind of a tie. I like Ransom's just like voice a little more, you know, like in terms of things. But when you listen to Russ's lyrics, it can appeal to more me, more my lifestyle versus what a Ransom's lifestyle is. So I guess it kind of just depends on what it is. If you're a super Ransom fan, you probably might tip the you might tip it to Ransom.
Best in the resurrection, which led to the effervescence, depression, compression, chest, and you better respect the legends. Get wet and protect your melon. You bled when the lead was spreading. You bled through your red intestines. You dead when your head is swelling. I slept with the weapon. The Smith and Wesson rest in my dresser drawer. He's so skinny, he can do push-ups under the exit door.
You know, listening to Papoose open this joint up, and I've never been like the deepest into Papoose at all, but I always respect him because every time I just hear him off the whatever, off a feature or anywhere, I just always respect him. He cool. And I like him as a person more than anything. And he can spit. Like, nigga, if you're a weak MC, he's eating you for breakfast. But it almost seemed like he like shooting little subliminals at Russ on this joint, which I'm sure Russ welcomes. He'd do a record with somebody he hates just to prove that, you know, he can rock with him. See, what Russ wins is he's melody driven. So he's almost like a Drake who can bar up on you, but still like melody you out. And that's hard to compete with when you bring hip hop and R&B into your presence. Like Papoose's verse was actually better. I just feel like the performance of Russ on this beat, he made it. He draked it.
I heard a non-platinum going, nigga, say something. Heard the album last night, at best it was alright. Got some hoes coming, no vain shit, we can play from it. Every other song, you get a drink on, spray some. Raised off Hov and Nas, keep the niggas away from us. Hit the drums on this bitch and think Dr. Dre coming. He not, it's the one man D-block. It's a best rebound, so three shots, feeling like three blocks.
Okay, so we got the game and Russ squaring off on this one. And Russ kind of tossed it up for the game because, like, this is a West Coast influenced beat. I'm sure Russ probably made it. He could tap into that West Coast sound very easily, it seems like. Because this is reminiscent of, like, some early 2000, mid to late 2000 shit. Like, this song sounds like it could be on the Wash soundtrack. Russ did his thing, but I feel like Game got him just because Game, just as a feature, he used this and really got poignant, really like updated his life and like made you remember who he is all within this record. I'd have to tip it to the game. And I fuck with the game hard because the game fuck with me. I would have had a fucking feature with the game this year if I could have produced the racks. I don't have enough money. And he gave me a deal too. That's the sad part. This nigga cut me a deal and I couldn't meet it.
Yeah, sun is beaming down, I'm wrapped up in the light. We never be fulfilled, cause with the meal comes the appetite. Banner white, I make a fortune, y'all just tapping on the screen. She asking me if I'm a player, about a draft on the team. I gather steam from my shattered dreams and let it propel me. I got the juice like Martinelli, my success is stealthy.
It's one of those, it's very East Coast driven in its beat. You know, like it's hard to not go to Rockefeller when you hear some shit like this. Because it's just it's that grind music that wake up early and it's cold. You got West Side Gunn, which is like the perfect guy from Griselda to get on a beat like this. It seemed like he sent that nigga this beat and that nigga was just like, he had an orgasm. He was like, oh, you want me on this? Bro, I do this in my sleep, cuz. Like, he already had a verse for this. He didn't even have to write this. He just had one loaded up for it. It's Ninth Wonder, you know? And it sounds Ninth Wonder. But this record is, you don't need this in your life. You really don't. You've heard this song before.
Real, I do me all. I got big in Madrid like Real. Now they scream rust like I play for the Seahawks. I eat off my own plate, big dough. The dough didn't open, so I went in through the window. 6 more months, that's like 6 more ends. I'ma go forever while your disco ends.
Alright, so Russ stepping it up here. He know, I see the track list and he on here with Jada Kiss. I haven't heard Jada Kiss yet. But Russ is doing his thing on here. Russ is spitting on this motherfucker. I like it. You know what I mean? He's being fluid. You know, he's very fluid on this record. And you have to be when you hopping on a record with Jadakiss. You knew Jada was coming for your ass. You can't get on this joint slumming because Jada is so fucking, like, and he reproved it to the world again and again and again. He always will. If you forgot, he'll prove it again. That's why I say right here, I can't tip it to nobody because Jada brought Jada to the fucking shit. He's just the king of the puns for me. Like when I first started hearing niggas be like witty in their rhymes, like really witty, like a lot often in one verse, it was Jadakiss, bro. I was like, damn, Jadakiss. Like, that's why I say a Lil Wayne had to look up to a Jadakiss. Like, anybody who you think is the most clever nigga, it started with kind of a Jadakiss.
Free. I'm free from all the bullshit of these labels. No suck and dive and hill. Nah. No tap dancing on tables. Nah. This ain't no Bojangles flow. This more like a bag. I throw some ice on my fist. Man, won't come thicker than grits forever. More tired of click. You be the same if you from where I'm from. Shit. Made a meal out of crumbs with my words in the funds. Cream of the crop out the slums. I might shine in the sun. Matrix glitch. The toes are going to package air from my lungs.
So DJ Premier came through with like, he going back to his roots on some Texas shit with this beat. It's very country, but super hip hop. He know how to blend those worlds better than anybody. You know, you get Big Crit on here, who Big Crit is just a hybrid himself. He's this southern dude, but like with this like up north flow, who could flow with really anybody. He's very dynamic. The pressure really is on like Snoop Dogg to keep up with these young niggas. Like Snoop almost sound like Eminem. Recovery album type shit.
Eyes of society quietly walk with lepers. When they plug into the matrix, babies have dreams of making love on a spaceship. You can hear atheist cries in the sub when the bass hit. The way that God brought me up from nothing was quite miraculous. The way I navigated the headless horsemen and Draculas was otherworldly. The whites of my eyes is mother pearly.
I like the way Russ spitting on him. Russ was, I actually really enjoyed the Russ verse. And I don't know why I gotta always like say that, because he's like trying to come for the very top five MCs. He can't get there. I'm sorry. It's just too many great MCs. And you too much of a baby, baby of a baby to be there. Like, it's hard. Even Kendrick is the greatest of us. And, you know, he's not necessarily there. It's always a gift when you get J Electronica, because he's in that, he's otherworldly. Like, where he is, when he come to do hip hop, he owe it to hip hop. He's a servant of life. So when you hear him do hip hop, that's just him coming to work. He's reporting to work. He's not really trying to entertain you. He's not trying to get booty shaking. He's not trying to be super famous so he can get ass or be exalted in no type of way. He's just fucking reporting for work and duty. Because when he speak, most people don't understand it, but I do. So I like, it's like food for me. But if you're not hip hop, you're not eating.
Fact, different levels to this boss shit. Always had drive, Ryan Gosling. Since I had a notebook full of rhymes, they rhyme like Lloyd Laughlin. They mouses for the green like I'm in Boston. But I'm in ATL. I employ myself and I pay me well.
I am not going front. He's been very impressive on this project. It's some verses that he got on here that's like, I mean, you know, you could tell he's a hybrid of everything that came before him and really showing it. He's not doing things that haven't been done before, but he's really doing it well. And I don't like Big Sean's verse as much as I love Russ's, but Big Sean definitely is Big Sean. Sean always kind of keep you in this cool, like, place, you know. But he was way too cool. Russ was coming in for the kill. And Big Sean was just coming in for the swag and the look and just the kind of Wale. I'm a Wale student, so Wale, he didn't phone this in, but it's not his greatest verse as far as flow-wise. Flow-wise, he could have went apeshit, but he was like, all right, it's a feature. I don't know if he knew who was going to be on it or what, but he knew he was going to be on Rush shit. And he kind of just played around on it. You know, he used words that he don't really use. He just played around, you know, and he just had fun in a flow that he's done a billion times.
So cathartic, finished every beat from rapper started. I swear I'm about to eat, I eat Bubardic, I see my target. I want the throne and then I'm ghost like I'm Omari Harvin. I'm Bonnie Clark, y'all got no heart, this money's Robert Jarvis. Do a cartridge, make your queen just disappear, cause I see in a week what you see in a year.
With this one, I don't really like this. Just because he's trying to be a little, it's like you could tell he didn't write to this. Like, and he said it at the beginning. He was like, I got something for it. Like, when the rappers say, I got something for this, they're not talking about just something about to spit off the top. They usually got something in the tuck already that I could spit on this. But it's like, I don't like him on this. Like, his type of texture, what he brings to records, I don't like him on this one.
Shit on. My name is tatted on titties and asses, cause I got a cold following like Indianapolis. My passion took me past the pessimist, cash benefits, first class Emirates, impact megalith, set in stone, win it wrong. I'ma do what Russ does, got a custom, skipping customs, what's up?
Okay. Now I see what's up. I like this beat. This beat is my vibe completely. Like I might nab this motherfucker if I can find it. Conway the Machine, boop 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 boop. He out here. He always be out here, man. I fucking love this nigga. He's really the him and Benny are the front runners of that crew to me, man. Both of them are very dynamic in themselves, and I love it. I love every time I see Conway on a bill. His presence, I just kind of like better than Russ. Even though Russ did his thing, you know, but Conway get on this joint, it's like you almost wish Conway put this on his album. Hey, yo, Ghostface in the building, man. Ghostface was always one of my favorite out of the Wu-Tang Clan. They were so dynamic. They just got so many personalities that even over time, you have to appreciate you slept on certain members at a certain point. But I never slept on Ghostface because Ghostface was always like mysterious to me. But then he revealed himself in the 2000s to me. And I was like, oh, I fucking love this nigga. And so to hear him come back on a Russ record is dope.
Got to get it by any means. I fight fires, dance around the doubters, wearing heavy boy like Mike Myers. I'm a live wire up from Mayho. Shot to start the war like Sarajevo. Crusader for the artist like I play for Valparaiso. I just raised the standard. First out made history. I made him change the banners. And
so all I gotta say is Lloyd Banks caught these niggas slipping. That's all I'm gonna tell you. Dynamic spit. You got Russ, Saha the Prince, and then Lloyd Banks. You know, it's like a really dynamic group that I would have never put together, but I want to see it. You know, type of deal.
Yeah, I'm watching a little raspy, something.
Yeah. Hey, I'm up till noon, strategizing and overthinking, dancing with my doubt, agitated, I know the rhythm, I know I'm tripping cause I'm not tripping, this is not the last dance, this is bullshit, I'm not Scott Pippen.
Hey, I mean, I really like both of these niggas on here, Mozzie and Russ, dope beat, it's just fun to listen to these young niggas, man, and see where they at, see how they kicking it, and I like the intricateness, cause they not being generic, but they really digging. Like if you're a surface level listener of hip hop, you're gonna miss everything they saying. You know, even if you high level, you're gonna miss some things. But like that's what forced you to listen to it more.
Let me talk to you. Yeah. My brand, everybody is toasting. They proud, they know you, they be bragging and boasting. They all sleep, everybody just dips cause they love you and everything's golden.
It's a little vibe. I ain't gonna front, it's a little vibe to it. I got vibes like this though, that's way better and way more in depth and passionate, and there it's kind of like he taking a super passionate vibe but bringing it into a lighter tone, which I respect, but yeah, you know, it's an ushering out record. But Russ scored a 42, which is an album that's got to grow on you. It got to grow on me. Definitely I have my little favorites from it. Spitting wise, you're gonna get some bars, man. I'm really proud of Russ. And this is an album that you can't critique just as an album. You're going to take one-offs from it because it's just like really an ego album. He going up against his kind of favorite or people who covered hip hop in a very deep way. He don't win every record, you know, he lose some, but he wins some. He wins some very convincingly and gets some very good, great artists actually. So you got to give him his props, man. He's definitely solidifying himself within the culture of hip-hop as a spitter on this one, so I respect that. I didn't hear the first chomp, so I can't even compare it to the first one. Maybe the first one was similar. Shout out to Russ, man. Keep killing this game. This is like his fucking 15th album, 16th album, some shit like this. So he's been putting the work in, and so any success he gets, he deserves. Daybots did it, man. Tap in right now. Go to Daybots did it. Get something. Just support, man, because it's going to come back to you tenfold. Blessedtings.com. Get over there. Just trust me. Trust me. Swim around, man. Get connected in your neighborhoods and your places, you know what I mean, and support what you support. I love y'all. Be easy breezy. Until next time.